We need to change the way that we design, use and reuse plastics. Our goal is to accelerate the transition towards a circular economy. I was a solo sailor and I'd spend months at a time at sea. I managed in 2005 to be the fastest person ever to sail solo non-stop around the world. When you leave for a round the world journey, you take with you the minimum you need for your survival. So you develop this overwhelming understanding of what it is to have finite resources. And it really struck me that our global economy was just the same as the boat. We have finite resources available to us and we're using them up. In a linear economy, you take a material, you make something out of it, and at the end of the use of the product, it gets thrown away. Within a circular economy, right from the outset, you design that product so that at the end of the life of the product, it can either cycle again as a product or the materials can be recovered. To create a circular economy for plastics, we need to eliminate the plastic that we don't need, we need to innovate for the plastic that we do, and we need to make sure that that plastic is then cycled. Since we began our journey on plastics, we've worked with businesses and policymakers. We have over 1,000 organisations globally working on this. We have the global commitment, which has got about 20% of the global plastic packaging industry signed up to a circular economy for plastics. We need to shift the system so circular products become the norm, and then everybody has circular products because that's how the economy runs. The circular economy is an economic opportunity. It provides new jobs in the regeneration of products, in the production of services. It's an opportunity to recover materials and design out waste and pollution. And if we get this right and we innovate and we're creative, we can build an economy which can thrive and which can run forever. Let's turn the tide on single-use plastics. Let's beat plastic pollution.